शंभस्य ज्ञानंजन शलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्री गुरवे वंशाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्यैव च पतितानां पावने वैष्णवे नमो महावदन्याय कृष्णप्रेमाय कृष्णाय कृष्णचैतन्ये गौरविषये गुरवे गौरचन्द्राय कृष्णाय कृष्णभक्ताय वास्मि माई कोटि कोटि दंडोत प्रणाम इन द लोटस फीट ऑफ माई परमाराध्य ओम विष्णु पाद सोतर श्रीमद भक्ति ज्ञान के स्वरूप and the same koti koti dandvat pranam in the lotus feet of my shiksha guru om vishnu pada sutta sasna bhakti vedanta swami maharaj After that, what I have told before, perhaps was until last year, I don't remember, that Brahma, Shankar, all demigods, came to Dwarka in the palace of Krishna. And they told, We have requested and prayed you to come to this world to take the bhubhar, burden of this prithvi. So, it is finished now. We have killed Utana, Agasur, Bakasur, Trinavarta, so many in Vrindavan, so many in Mathura, Kansa, Charun, Mostri, his brothers, And Jarasandha, 17 times with Akshamani Sena, unlimited army. And then, also in Mahabharata Yuddha, you have killed yourself or by your arms, Bhuja arm. Oh, Bhima and Arjun, you have killed all the demons who were first Devasur, Sangram, Asur. Now they have come in the form of Kshatriya. So you have killed. Krishna told, I know. You have reminded me. I have done everything. But if I will go now, Then Jadubansi will create so many troubles. So before me, I should finish them. So, he inspired Durvasa and other rishi, and they gave cause to Jadunad dynasty. They will be finished burning each other. So Krishna told all Jadubansi, some unauspicious things are seen. We should go to Prabhastitha, very sacred place. We will donate Brahmins and we will satisfy them. All went there. and fire sacrifice was done, but they took marine any
wine
and then forget everything. Who is brother, his father, who is mother, who is he? They fighting each other, finished. But I have told, this was only magic of Krishna. By this, he sent all his associates, some in heaven, some in Vaikuntha, some in Dwarka, and some in Braja. In this way. Mass marriage in one day. And then, Baldev Prabhu left his body. In a snake form he came. And then he went to Golok Vrindavan. And after that, Krishna was sitting on the peepal tree as if nothing has been done. Atma Aram. Atma Kam, everything. And in the meantime, Uddhav came. He told that, I know. Now you want to return back to your Golok Vrindavan. I cannot live without you. So please take me with you. And then Krishna told, something remaining for you. You have to be in this world. What I am telling to you now, Bhagavad Dharma, how easily a blind man can also follow the process and they can achieve Supreme Lord's prem, I will tell you. And you should tell first to Vidur in the way. And then you should go to Badrikashram. And then tell to Maitreya Rishi. And then he will tell everywhere. And you should be there. Sometimes you can be in Braja. So sometimes in Kusum Sarovar, Uddhav Kunda, as a blade of cross, he is wetting the feet, dust of gopis. When Krishna, gopis will go to Abhishek to meet Krishna. So Uddhav is there. So at that time, Uddhav requested, whole world is entangled in Grihastha Dharma. So how they can be liberated and how they can have Krishna prem? Then Krishna began to tell, you should give up worldly life. It is like blind whale, burning fire. Give up at once and be renounced. Give up everything, all attachment in this world. And you can travel in whole world like Narada. Especially, Kaliyuga is Mahan Yuga. Demigods even, all those who are very intelligent, they want to be in Kali Yuga. Guna Grahi, all. Because here in Kali Yuga, Keval Nam Sankirtane na Sartha Abhilabdhati. By Nam Sankirtan, by singing the glory of Krishna, Roop, Naam, quality and other things, easily they can achieve everything. More than that, then in Sapta Yuga by Dhyan, Treta Yuga, Yajna, and Dwapar, Archan, in Kali Yuga, friends. If a man only thinks that I should do this bad thing, if has not done in activities, then no sin. Understand? By mind, if he is doing so many nonsense things, but not by body. In Kali Yuga, not fruitful. If he will do by body and senses, then, so Kali Yuga has so many things. That is why wise and intelligent person, they want to come in Kali Yuga.
Positive
things,
positive reaction in Kali Yuga.
What else? If my mind thinks so many positive things, favorable things, this will
bear fruit. This will give fruit, but bad things not. And then Krishna told that Jadu was very religious person in my family before. He has so much love and affection from Brahmins and Rishis. One day he saw a naked person properly, not begging anything from anyone. But still he was so much healthy. So, and he was very, very happy. Jayatma Sampasya. Because he was always remembering Krishna, his pastimes. So Jadu did pranam and then took his feet dust on his head and told, I want to know, you are naked, you have no, oh no, sangraha nahi.
No possession.
Sangraha means?
You have not earned anything.
Any collection with you, nothing, quite naked, here and there, going and there. But yet, why you are so happy? And why you are so healthy? I want to know. Then Dattatreya, he was Dattatreya, manifestation of God. He told, O Jadu, there are 24 gurus. They are my all siksha guru. Prithvi, earth, air, akash, sky, water, fire, chandra, surya, pigeon, Ajagar, python, samudra, ocean, patanga, yes, patanga,
insect,
hora,
bumblebees,
or madhumakhi, and elephant. Oh, those who take shahad, madhu from honey collector, deer, fish, pingala besya, kurar prachi, any bird, balak, baby, and Kumari Kanya, unmarried girl, and any Baan Banane Wala, Arrow maker. And serpent, snake, makadi,
spider.
And bringikit.
Wasp.
We will explain further all these things. Oh, Jadu, Maharaj, I met this 24 Shiksha Guru. And I have learned so many things from them. And that is why I am happy. I am not attached to anyone. And thus traveling in cold world. Sometimes, sheep car, hiding myself, sometimes, like now I am visible for you only to give you mercy, and sometimes traveling but not anyone knows. Who is he? He is a mad person. And sometimes by mercy to give for that benefit, I
manifest.
Now I am manifesting myself and telling mercifully. Oh, from earth, who will tell? From earth.
From the earth, I learned patience. Guruve Gaura Chandraya Radhikaya Tadale Krishnaya Krishna Bhaktaya Tadabhaktaya Namo Namaha. So I have 24 Shiksha Gurus. Amongst them, first is Earth. Because from the Earth I learned patience. Just like Mother Earth, many good persons, many bad persons walk upon her, pass stool on her, pass urine on her, always taking from her. But she is so kind, like millions of mothers, she is always tolerating. One is like the moon. The moon appears to manifest different phases. Sometimes it's full moon, sometimes quarter moon, sometimes new moon. But the moon itself is unaffected by the so-called changes that it manifests. In the same way, the Atma is completely unaffected by different manifestations, means different bodies that it may take. One guru is the mountain. Because the mountain, everything the mountain has is for the benefit of others. Another is the tree, because everything the tree has is also for the benefit of the others. One guru is like, then five gurus. Like fire, earth, water, fire, air, and sky. I learned that one should be a saintly person is like fire. Because no matter what objects we put in fire, the fire accepts those objects but remains unaffected by them. In the same way, a sadhu may move in this world. There may be so many varieties of good and bad, but the sadhu accepts them, what is necessary for his maintenance, but remains unaffected by them. A sadhu is also like, a saintly person should be like water. Because unlike me, water makes a very pleasing sound. Anyone who contacts water becomes very cooled and purified. In the same way, a saintly person is like water, because he makes very nice sound of Harikatha, and anyone who contacts him, they become pure and peaceful. I learned that one should be like the ocean, isn't it? Like in the rainy season, many, the rivers are full and they rush towards the ocean, but the ocean does not rise up. In the dry season, there is no water going in the ocean, but ocean remains.
Thank you. Vaishnava should be very tolerant. Like earth. Sometimes we dig earth to obtain anything. Sometimes we pass urine and latrines. Do so many things But Prithvi Devi, Bhu Devi, oh, very tolerant. See, don't tell.
Never protest.
Why you are doing so? So she is very tolerant. So you should be tolerant like earth. Especially in earth, trees and creepers. Trees. How tolerant? Trinadapi tarorapi sahishruna. Their bark, their juice, their fruit, their flowers, their food, everything is for others. So Vaishnava, everything what he has, it should be for all. Tree even does not want water. He will dry. But never, oh, give me water. And if he will cut his branch, even he will tolerate. Then Vaishnava, Vaishnavi, try to learn this. Otherwise, how Vaishnava? And also, Parvat,
mountain.
We do so many nonsense things, but she tolerates. Their life, their everything, position, is for others. So yours also should be like that. Don't have any position, nothing. Don't collect. And then, Sasvat Parartha Sarveha, Pran Vayu. Can you tell? Pran Vayu. 38 is low.
Om Jnanatimirandasya Jnananjanashalakaya Chakshurun Vilitam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha. So the next verse is speaking about the mountain.
No,
that has been done.
Sasvat Parartha Sarve.
Shashvat Pararta Sarveha Parartai Kanta Sambhava Sadhu Shiksheta Bhu Britto Nagashishya Paratma Tam. A saintly person should learn from the mountain to devote all his efforts to the service of others and to make the welfare of others the sole reason for his existence. Similarly, as the disciple of the tree, he should learn to dedicate himself to others. This is what you spoke about.
After that, yes.
Then prana vrittyaiva santushyan. Prana vrittyaiva santushyan munir naivindriya priyai jnanam yata nanashyeta navakiryeta van manaha. A learned sage should take his satisfaction in the simple maintenance of his existence, and he should not seek satisfaction through gratifying the material senses. In other words, one should care for the material body in such a way that one's higher knowledge is not destroyed, and so that one's speech and mind are not deviated from self-realization. Then it goes on to the next verse. You about wind? Vayu? Yeah. Even a trout.
Learn from prana vayu. Yeah. That is light vayu.
Light air.
That?
Oh, yeah. Now in the next shloka it tells.
Only what our belly wants. Only simple and pavitra.
Pure.
We should take not much more or less. Only to maintain life. Not for rasana. This is very sweet, this is very tasteful, this is that. No. So, you should take, you remember, patyahara prayasasya prajalpo niyamatra janasangasya loulancha sarbi bhakti. So, for taste, don't take. Only take prasadam to maintain any house life. And also, like vayu, this vayu, air, flows everywhere. Take scent of artha, flowers and everything. Bad thing also, stool and other things. But always
detached.
Auspicious. Because there is no attachment to anyone. So we should be like that. We should travel here and there to maintain our life also, preaching also, but be careful. Never be attached to anyone. Have expend attachment and affection both. So don't attach. Further they will all explain. So air does not take any bad quality or good quality. This is of earth and always auspicious. But so, sadhak, we tolerate bhook, pyaas,
hunger and thirst,
and other things. Bhook, pyaas and all other things are not of Atma. It is of body. And we are not this body. Like Akash.
Sky.
Sky is in blue, but sky is nothing. It is the air it looks like. No? Also, anywhere, fire, or so much cold, so much rain, coming from sky, but not from sky. So we should try to be like a sky, not attached, everywhere attachment. Don't attach. So I have made this sky my siksha guru. That we should know that Atma is pure, Krishna Das. And nobody has come, don't have this Atma Buddhi. From Agni. Tejasvi tapasa dipto दुर्धर्षो ओदर्भाजन सर्वक्षो अपि युक्तात्मा नादत्ते मल अग्निवत्। Anyone? Oh, you will?
You read the translation, because then...
Translate.
Tejasvi tapasa dipto...
Tejasvi...
Tejasvi, yes. Yeah. Tejasvi tapasa dipto dur-dharshodara bhajana sarva-bhakshyopi yuktatma Nadate malam agnivat. Saintly persons become powerful by execution of austerities. Their consciousness is unshakable because they do not try to enjoy anything within the material world. Such naturally liberated sages accept foodstuffs that are offered to them by destiny. And if by chance they happen to eat contaminated food, they are not affected. Just like fire, which burns up contaminated substances that are offered to it.
What meaning?
So the lesson is being learned from fire. All these 24 different Siksha gurus, they are manifestations within the material nature. So this pure sage, he was able to learn lessons from all different aspects of nature. Now he's describing fire. Fire, if you feed anything into fire, what happens to it? It becomes completely burnt up in that fire. The fire does not become affected at all by it, and the fire is always pure. So in the same way, a saintly person who wanders within this world, he may eat this kind of foodstuff, very good, very palatable, or he may eat some foodstuffs which are even a few days old. In any condition, whatever he contacts, it does not affect him at all, because he is completely pure, like the fire. He has fully realized his transcendental position as the Atma, that he has no connection with the external material world. And therefore, when he is accepting articles, consuming different articles, different foodstuffs, he is not affected by that. He is completely transcendental, just as the fire is always pure.
Like fire. Fire burns, stone, urine, auspicious thing, unauspicious thing, but not taking anything. Nothing. So Vaishnava should only to maintain life. He will have some thing, but he should not be entangled. As what is fire? Have you seen fire? No. What is burning? If some wood, bakra, is burning, you will see that fire is...
There's a shape.
If it is flat, you will see the fire is flat. In forest, you will see, oh, big fire. But this is not fire. Fire is everywhere. In your heart also, that we digest. We prefer fire. So, sometimes it is visible, sometimes not visible. But these are flames, not fire. Fire is a power. Material power of Krishna. So we should be like that. Maintaining our life anyhow, we should not be attached to anything in this world. And then...
Samayaya Shushtam.
from Chandra. Can you? Chandra.
Visargadya Shmashananta Bhava Dehasya Natmana Kalanam Iva Chandrasya Kalena Vyakta Vartmana. The various phases of one's material life, beginning with birth and culminating in death, are all properties of the body, and they do not affect the soul, just as the apparent waxing and waning of the moon does not affect the moon itself. Such changes are enforced by the imperceptible movements of time.
Can you explain?
So, Om Aginati Mirandasya Gyananjala Shalakaya Chakshu Unmalitam Jena Tasmai Shri Guruve Namaha. So, the moon, in its waxing and its waning, is not affected itself, just like the soul is not affected by the changing body. The body will change from youth to boyhood to old age, but the Atma will not change at all. And similarly, the moon, when it goes through its 16 phases, that the moon is the same, but it appears to be different, but actually the moon is one. So, similarly, so the soul remains the same, although the bodies are changing.
When changes come, it is due to body.
Body, only body.
So Chandra is one, always in full, but due to rotation of sun, earth and moon, we see that today is Pratipada, first moon, second moon, third moon, like this. But if you will go very high, you will see that moon is always
same size.
Full moon. It is due to rotation of all these things. So, soul is one not affected by all these things. What we see, some reduce or some gradually develop in moon, it is due to rotation. So, Atma is always full. All bhuk, pyaas,
hunger,
thirst, and all these things are of body. Atma is not affected at all. So you should be like that. You are not body. You are soul, part and parcel, always happy. Nitya das of Krishna. So, you should be unaffected like. And then, Manjari, you should come and sing one kirtan. My Shiksha Guru is son. He takes all water from this world, even from ocean. And then he gives as a barsha, like rainfall. No collection, nothing. So, if you have any collection, donate it, don't keep, otherwise like fire. To donate to whom? not to be shy for the service of Hari Guru Vaishnava. Utilize
and then
pigeon. I have learned something from pigeon. What? You don't know? You?
Right to understand and if you will understand
I will say and keep in your heart you will never be unhappy. I see so many are unhappy because they don't take my teachings. Otherwise, they will be. We call sufferings ourselves. Don't call.
So, Dattatreya Rishi, among all his Siksha Gurus, one of them is a pigeon. Once, a pigeon lived in the forest with his mate, and they were very much attached to each other. They had built a very beautiful nest. And it is said that the she pigeon, she was very coquettishly cajoling her husband whenever she wanted something from him. And because her husband didn't control his senses, naturally he would do everything she said. It is said that someone who has not controlled his senses naturally would be attached to the opposite sex. Srila Gaugamana Maharaj used to say, everyone in this world wants to enjoy the chakrapala, the round-shaped fruit. I like your face, I like your breast, I like your buttocks. He would say like that. Everyone who has not controlled his senses is there. So those two lovey-dovey birds, they were very much attached to each other. And naturally, in the course of time, then she experienced her first pregnancy and she laid so many eggs in the nest. And then, by the grace of the Lord, then those nests turned into very beautiful little baby pigeons with their chirping very awkwardly. And their parents, naturally, like all parents, they fell completely in love with those little birds. And they forgot everything. And they were flying around, going, you know, to find all kind of food to bring to the birds. Now, one hunter, he had noticed that, oh, there are so many bird droppings under that tree, so there must be a nest there. So he came and he found, oh, those little pigeons are there. So he spread his net and he caught all the pigeons. When the both parents came, when the mother saw her pigeons, baby pigeon there, she was so attached, she could not tolerate it. And very foolishly, she tried to help them, and she also got caught. Now, the male pigeon, he was completely mesmerized, you know, by the beauty of his wife and attachment to his children. So he started to lament, oh, by the will of providence, this has happened. I could not satisfy myself, he says, I could not satisfy myself. Meaning that no matter how much enjoyment one gets in this world, in the household or ashram, there is no satiation, there's no satisfaction, no matter what. And this pigeon, he was a pakagrihamedi, and therefore he had enjoyed his senses like anything, still he was not satisfied. And he was saying, oh, those beautiful children, they are like saintly persons. He was completely bewildered. Then they are now in the grip of death, and he was lamenting, what did I do? I did not perform pious activities. He was completely in a dream. And this is the fate of everyone in this world who is attached to the opposite set. Deha patrakara tradishu atma sanyashu asatsvapi tesham pramatonidam paschana pinapaschati. Those who are so attached to the body, an extension of the body, wife, children, house, everything. Then, although they see, they do not see. Although they see the life is passing every day, still they do not realize that everything here will have an end. So it is said, if we have, there shouldn't be any attachment to wife, children, money, bank account. If there should be any attachment, it should be to the Lord who is so dear to the devotees.
So, pigeon was she pigeon, male pigeon, so much attached to lady pigeon and to their children. So one day she and he pigeon went to forest to collect some grain or some food. And the in time hunter came. And what did he saw that there are some baby pigeons. And he took them home. And he kept in his
net.
When they returned from forest, oh, my children. So sea pigeon at once went there. And she was in the net of that behavior. And after that, he pigeon, he lost his everything. Oh, my dear, this wife to whom she was very helping to me, favorable. She always obeyed me, always. So, without him, her, how can I pass my life? And so, there came, and hunter also took them. And what became? He took them all, and he went to his house, returned very happy, and cooked them. And so, you should learn something from this, all this. That is why I called and I am telling this 11th canto, though very hard, but so much learning is there. We should learn and teach it. And also teach it to others also. Very powerful this. Who is telling? Krishna himself telling. This is a story of Dattatreya and Jatra. So you should think about this and be like this for your own maintenance. You should take something. Don't keep it with you extra. Don't attach it with anyone. Then, now, any drama play?
Yes.
Oh, then.